In this new series, Breakthrough with Prayer, we combine our popular brand of quick wisdom with a strong, sincere, and highly relevant prayer. Double blessing for you. The actual prayer, called The Certain Future, follows immediately after we share this quick wisdom explanation. Thank you. When there is a certainty, the heart and the mind have no fear. But when perilous times come, the Word and Spirit of God will calm your thoughts and give you wisdom to live victoriously. We never dreamed that this earthship could face such a perfect storm. The ship's anchors have nothing to hold on to in this COVID-19 pandemic. Uncertainty happens when the events of the present are confusing, when the present dark clouds hide the sun and plague the future with fear and risk. But the perfect storm cannot prevail over our perfect God. He is our strong anchor in Christ Jesus. God will support and give strength to those who are loyal to Him. Our hope is in the Lord. Our trust is in the Lord, not in man. Some nations boast of their chariots and horses, but we boast in the name of the Lord our God. Mary Fowler Maud, the hymn writer, says it well. We have an anchor that keeps the soul steadfast and sure while the billows roll, fastened to the rock which cannot move, grounded firm and deep in the Savior's love. After that introduction, I'd now like to talk to you about the certainty behind today's reality. There are five realities happening simultaneously. 1. A rampant pandemic virus. 2. Global economic recession and social breakdown. 3. People dying by the hundreds of thousands in a short period. 4. Confusing events, flawed medical data, fake news and conspiracy theories. 5. Trial and error responses by governments and authorities all over the world. Reality is seen, it's heard, it's observed. All about objective matters. That's what reality is. But truth answers the question, who has the power over reality? Let's look at the reality of a rampant pandemic virus. The spirit behind it is the fear of infection. Uneasiness prevails. The certainty? Be still my heart. God is God. I take God at His word. Let's look at the second reality. Global economic recession and social breakdown. The spirit behind is the fear for livelihood and social affiliation. And so disturbing thoughts prevail. The certainty? Be still my heart and mind. Rise, spiritual gifts, with power, love, and a sound mind. Psalm 37:25 says, God never forsakes the people whose heart is right with God. They are never left helpless, and their children have never gone begging for food. Learn to take God at His word. Reality number 3. People dying by the hundreds of thousands in a short period of time. The spirit behind is the fear of possible death at the door. Stalking, ready to strike, striking terror in the heart and the mind. The certainty. Again, be still my heart and mind. My God values me more than the birds of the air. He will take care of me. I take my God at His word. The fourth reality, confusing events, flawed medical data, fake news, and conspiracy theories. The spirit behind this is fear from confusion. It can consume every waking minute and torment a person. The certainty? Be still my heart and mind. Stay in perfect peace from our God. You must take God at His word. Reality number 5. Trial and error responses by governments and authorities. The spirit that rises is the fear of national collapse, of anarchy. It brings anxiety and fretting prevails. The certainty, be still my heart and mind. God is my fortress. Psalm 46 says it beautifully. God is our refuge and strength, an ever-present help in times of trouble. Therefore, we will not fear. Though the earth is transformed and the mountains toppled into the depths of the seas, though their waters roar and foam and the mountains quake in the surge. Believe that God has the power over reality. Take God at His word. Let me talk to you now about new beginnings and sure stability. Times change, seasons change, life changes. Even during life, there is the approaching end, which is death. Our hope is that things change for our good. Our experiences of life tell us that life swings between periods of stability and periods of uncertainty. Often, during the one, we find the other. Life teaches us to live with this cycle or this circle. This is how we grow, how we develop, how we change. The Bible depicts this with a sure promise. In Romans 8:28 it says, all things work together for the good of those who love God, those whom He has called according to His plan. Now, rapid changes and uncertain futures can stun you and block your progress. Prayer in uncertain times is like a light in the darkness. In prayer, God can open your heart and your mind to ways you can adapt and take the initiative. The power of prayer during rapid change and uncertain future is its spiritual guidance. God can open your heart, open your mind, and your abilities to personal initiative and adaptability. In this way, God brings stability into your life by His power and the presence of the Holy Spirit. Your ship, remember the analogy of the ship we used right at the beginning? Your ship is then steady in a fierce storm. In any fierce storms, spiritual wisdom expels confusion. You gain the wisdom to use uncertainty and to use turbulence by the grace and presence of God, and to steer your ship to where He wants you to be for Him. New opportunities, new vistas. God is on your side. And now the prayer. This is not a passive prayer of surrender to uncertainty. It is a quiet prayer of victory in your life, in God, through Christ Jesus. So be blessed, the certain future.
Prayer is an open secret. It is a beautiful mystery.
All-knowing Father, I know that You are watching over me. When peril is possible, I look to You for protection. Where my stability is likely to be undermined, Your support will see me through. Teach me how to see ahead and to prepare for the opportunities and problems that might arise. And where the curtain of the future remains closed, grant me the ability to adapt to the things which tomorrow might bring. I pray that many good things happen, but whatever occurs, You will be there to guide me. Let anxiety give way to peace. Let uneasiness give way to courage. All these requests I place before You in the name of Christ Jesus. Amen. Please like and share this video and subscribe to our channel. Until the next time, this is Joel's Place in the Spiritual Lounge. Thank you.